Let's have a look at some functionalities and common errors that may appear when editing a project after the panel detection is done. We have already imported the demo project, edited as seen in the dedicated video. If there are closed paths on the canvas that have the same depth of cut as the wood panel thickness, they need tabs. The software forbids sending the project if these type of cuts do not have at least one tab. If you click Calculate Path in this situation, you will receive a warning message. To position the tabs, activate the Tab tool by clicking on its icon in the toolbar. Tabs work as links between the cut piece and the rest of the panel, allowing Goliath to move over the piece without moving the piece itself. They can be easily cut by hand at the end of the project. In this case, there is only one path that needs them, the outside square. To position the tabs, move the mouse close to the track and click. The tab is represented by a black dot over the path. When done, right-click or press the S key to deactivate the tab tool. You can now click Calculate Path. You will see that the software can now calculate the G-code correctly. Whenever you do a modification to the project or you reposition it, the software will ask you to recalculate the path before sending it to Goliath. The project may be positioned in a part of the canvas where Goliath cannot safely move, for example, when it is too close to a panel edge. In this case, the software will let you know that it cannot calculate the path and the whole figure will turn red. Now, if you click on Calculate Path, the software will deactivate the Send to Goliath button until the figure is repositioned and the path calculated again. The same goes if the figure is outside the canvas. In this case, an arrow will show up when calculating the path and the figure will turn red. Move the figure back on the canvas to proceed in sending the project to Goliath. Let's now discover the panel extension functionality. During the panel detection, you are asked to flag the two most accessible sides, in our case, the top and the right sides. On these sides, the panel extension can be added. Panel extension must have the same thickness of the wood panel to work. They help optimize the Goliath work surface by adding an area where Goliath's wheels can move. It is important to underline that Goliath cannot cut on the panel extensions. This space is reserved for Goliath's wheels. Panel extensions appear in the software when the project is positioned close to the flag edges. They are represented by red rectangles at the side of the canvas. In this case, you can see a panel extension appearing on the top edge. In the red square, you can find the width of the panel extension needed and the checkbox that needs to be checked if the user can provide and add the panel extension next to the wood panel. You can now calculate the path, but you have to check the panel extension checkbox to send the project to Goliath. You will see that the button is gray until the panel extension is confirmed. Click Send to Goliath only when the panel extension is added to the real work surface. Once this is done, you can proceed to cut your project with Goliath, optimizing your wood panel area.